Ah, well, mon nom s'appelle SK.
They love me not. They love me. They love me not. Nappy roots tie me up in forget-me-nots. I remember age 4, sitting on my grandmother's veranda, the sun creeping its way ever so cautiously onto my lap. Sat on a bench, hair parted in 4, my tiny throw awaiting its braided destiny, a picture of simplicity. By the age of 7, my cousin decided my hair was too coarse to make sense of. Talent it is, it was streamed from my face every time she endeavored to plow my afro into submission, so she introduced me to a relaxer, which ironically stressed my scalp more than I could ever have imagined. But she said not to worry, it was just for me, and it would leave me completely kink-free. But I never quite looked like the little girls on the box. During a brief intermission, I tried my hand at Jericho, which left me looking like Michael Jackson circa bag. I wished I could have overturned conversations I remember overhearing about other little girls when I was younger, like, she has got good hair. I mean, you must have some Indian in you. Perhaps a mixed relative or two, because the way that your hair cascades down your back is simply phenomenal. I wish that one, just one of those people, would turn to me and say, you've got that great hair, you must be African. But that conversation never quite happened. University led me round full circle to my very own bench, parting my very own hair, allowing my follicles to bring forth life, rose blossom gorgeous, pandering to its every eccentric need. Queen, I can't help but wonder, how would you have chosen to wear your crown if you were never convinced that the kinks of your curl are not quite commercial enough? If it was never implied that the way that your strands fold back and embrace one another as if they are the only remaining survivors of a Holocaust isn't quite natural enough, isn't quite authentic enough, what would you have done? Would you have shaved your head bald, waved your mane, auctioned it off to the highest bidder as if you were Brazilian, if Madam C.J. Walker and Garrett Morgan never tried to make their millions by trying to make you look a little bit less like a slave? What would you have done? Would you have twisted it, threaded it, bantu knotted it, sister locked it? What would you have done? Would you have worn your afro like the moon, mocking its celestial beauty with your undeniable grace? What would you have done if you were never convinced that your hair was not beautiful? That if you ever knew that your hair was the best kind of bespoke, if you knew that your hair was truly beautiful? Thank you.